ProContractor submitting electronic copies of an AP invoice with cost plus and time and material invoices. This video is one in a series of videos designed to help you learn helpful tips and tricks you might not know about in ProContractor. To learn more about ProContractor and other Viewpoint solutions, check out Viewpoint's YouTube channel and subscribe to stay up to date on the latest and greatest content.
Have you ever found yourself having to put together copies of invoices to support a cost plus or a T&M invoice? The days of standing in front of the copier copying those invoices are over. Let's take a look at how we can easily manage that inside of ProContractor. So I wanted to show you where the particular log that I use for this task lives. So it's on the taskbar. You're going to go to Vendors, Invoices, and then I am a big fan of the View Project Vendor Invoices log. Of course, anything that starts with View is a log. So that is where this particular piece that we're looking at today resides. Okay, so what I did is I said, all right, hey, I need to look at all my project invoices for a specific project, right? I wanted to come in here and I sorted this just for the 4021 Paradise Road project. And I put in a date parameter. I just put in the month of March, but it could be 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, a year, a couple of days, right? You're free to put in whatever sort of date parameters you would like to put in here. And then you get a nice list of all of the vendors, the invoices. And as you are probably well aware, in our logs, you can create these views to include any type of information that you would like. I like this view myself. Build that view however you would like. But here's what I want to show for the magic of creating those copies of those invoices, because if you'll notice in the very bottom, I always, almost always, have the ability to export a view to Excel. But in this particular log, I have the ability to not only do that, but also to export the document files into Excel. And not only to the Excel for a list of the invoices, but the actual PDFs of the documents that are in that binder. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and export that. It's going to ask me which folder I want. Let's just call this March Invoices. All right. And I'm going to stick that, I'm going to export into that folder. Now what happens is you can see there's my folder. Here you can see an attachment index. And this is going to be an Excel spreadsheet that mimics that log view that we just looked at. The columns are there, all of the information. That's why those log views are really important. You may not want a customer to see all of the information that I had in my log. So make sure you're putting in the columns that you want to share on your log. But look at this, you guys. These now have hyperlinks that are hyperlinked to the invoices that are attached to that record, right? So there's my invoice for GTO, right? So all of this information that you see here, all these hyperlinks, that is hyperlinked to a actual PDF document that is attached as a part of that export. So you can take, now I can take that March Invoices folder, zip it up, and send it to my customer as backup for the cost plus or time and material invoices that I am doing for them.